worship, and we've always been worshiping. I'd like to welcome you to worship this morning. And a wave of announcements, we're starting a new sermon series today calling Move Mountains. Talk about harnessing the power of faith in God. If you have the faith of a mustard seed, you can move mountains. How can we go back into the society with that kind of power? We'll start this week talking about God being on the move. Talk real loud, like this. So whoever's microphone this is. Okay, so we are starting a new sermon series today called Moving Mountains. This is a series about harnessing our faith. It doesn't even have to be a big faith. The faith of a mustard seed can move mountains. And the sermon today will be later on posted, hopefully, on YouTube and Facebook. That is the plan. We will still be pausing for prayer as usual every time on Monday, Wednesdays, and Saturday nights, 7 o'clock. Usual place, usual channel, I guess.
Same time, same channel.
Same time, same channel, yes. For your offering, we have this little church over here. Make sure before you leave today that you put your Buddha in there. Your offering goes into the church. And I'd like to thank you for all the cards and calls and love that you sent for my mother passing away. I really appreciate it. I felt your love, and I really appreciated that time. Any other announcements that should be made?
At least we got a beautiful day to be out here.
Amen. Yes, it is a good day. So we're going to sing, This Is the Day, if I can get the music to play. Let's see. What is that? There we go. This is the day.
This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made. Let us rejoice. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
I guess we should have had a little more coffee before we got that. Take a time to share our joys and concerns. We've been collecting them in our prayer time, but I would like to collect them from you as a church family. So what is on your heart? And this is a time to share, because we can't really go up and snuggle up to each other, or we really shouldn't anyway. So if you have a time you want to talk and bring something up, time to share. Yes.
I have a couple concerns. First of all, I guess people know that my daughter Gabriella lives in Minnesota. She lives in St. Paul right now. She's not downtown in the midst of things, but fairly close, and it keeps getting wider. She also has to travel back and forth to the hospital. So I ask for safety for her in her house. Her best friend just had her gas lines and electric lines and was evacuated from her house, and she's living at my daughter's. So I asked for safety for that. My son-in-law, Jared, was called in to the tactical response team, which he's part of. He's a Cherry Hill policeman. He was called in to come help in Cherry Hill, where things have started in there. So I asked for safety for him. And I also asked for safety for both Gabriella and Krista, who are in the hospitals involved with the coronavirus. So, lots of prayers, please, for my girl.
the... This is the time. Y'all ain't seen each other. Don't act bashful all of a sudden. Okay, Margaret. Oh, I'm sorry, for Marlene, yes. If you don't know, Marlene had a mini stroke and she's still recovering. I believe she's on the list, but don't hurt to put on her twice. You never know with me. Anyway, Margaret, yes.
Yes. Everybody remembers Beulah Cobb, so pray for her. She is going through some issues right now. And also, Geneva Cobb, who has been in rehab since January the 31st, fell and broke her opposite hip. So she will have surgery tomorrow morning. So please pray for both of those ladies.
Beulah Cobb, who's had health issues now, and Beulah Cobb fell down and broke the other hip. Never good to break a hip alone, but... Yes, Charlie.
We had a bit of excitement in the neighborhood yesterday, and it ended well, but a 2.5-year-old boy disappeared yesterday, just down the street from me. Mexican boy. And we were all in a panic, running around the neighborhood, jumping in cars, and it ended very well. I heard a lot of hollering. I thought they were calling out his name, and they were rejoicing. They found him in the house in a closet.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
Must have been in trouble.
Right? Hiding in the closet under some clothes.
But that's a good answer to prayer.
Amen. And many thanks to all the people who did the grass, the books in the church, the sanitizing, the sound system. It takes a village
right
to put everything together.
Yes, I thank all who helps to set up and make things happen, because I don't just show up and then turn on a switch. Usually it's a 10-step process.
Money-wise to help us through this time.
Right.
Because we've actually missed 12 weeks
right
of offering.
Yes, thank you to everybody that kept the church afloat.
Yes. Thank you all that being faithful and those that are catching up today. And just thank you for that. There's so many that gave, like in my mother's name, things like that. So a lot of things added up to help sustain us. Anything else we want to be praying about? I have a whole bunch of lists that I've been praying every time we pray. I can go through those. Anyone else? We have the family of George Floyd for the big cities, for the riots that are going on, especially for Philadelphia. We also want to lift up those that we've been regularly lifting up. Lee, who's in hospice. That's my buddy over in Violent. Just for comfort. Bill Hall, who's still recovering. Those that we know that have the virus and are recovering, Kathy, Becky, Cheryl, Aaron, and Mike. We want to lift up Perry Ashman, who has cancer, and his wife, Marie, who is his caretaker. We want to lift up Marlene, we mentioned. She had a mini stroke. We want to lift up Mike, who has cancer. Continue prayers for him. I'm going to lift up the Blues, Ms. Mary, Joan Lanning, Beulah Cobb we mentioned, and Geneva Cobb. We also listed Hope Edwards on our list of some of our extended family that we also We also wanted to lift up the Johnsons and Craig, who had this break-ins, their house, just comfort, especially them. And we want to pray for our enemies. Pray for those. Let's go for them too, that justice will be found. We want to lift up our churches. Please lift up your pastors. All the help I can get. Lift up our DS, Reverend Conaway, as he leads us. We want to lift up our nursing homes. They've been really hit hard by the virus. We want to lift up Alexandria, who has leukemia. We want to lift up our healthcare workers and our frontline people they're still dealing with people's craft and dealing with the virus in general. We lift up our president and the governors and those that make decisions for us as to do with the virus. We also want to pray for the vaccine to be perfected. We want to lift up Jody. If you don't know, Jody Sutton is pregnant again, having a girl, I believe. They're coming back home, so they're coming back to Jersey. So she's asking for prayers for just a peaceful transition, for just healthy pregnancy. And they asked her for it on Facebook, so they asked me to share with you guys as well. We also list off Dina and Terry, who are nurses, you know, working in nursing homes. Dina's mom is in the soldier's home, so we want to lift up those that are in our homes that can't have visitors still. We want to lift up Kay Moore, who's still recovering from cellulitis. People asked for prayer for that spaceship it took off. Remember that came off yesterday and launched? Pray for safety. And there's also unspoken requests. Anybody else have anything else? That's funny. That's the kind of prayer ministry we've been doing, you know, since we've been not having church. We're still here, you know, and we've been ministering to our community. Let's go to God in prayer. Lord, we come to you and we take a moment of silence, Lord. We lift up those that have lost their lives through this virus, and we just take a moment of silence and remember them. Lord, we also lift up the family of George Floyd. We pray for comfort for them as they seek justice. We pray for our country, for the unrest and the disunity that is fathering. Just ask for your peace to be upon your people, that we would be a beacon of your love and your peace to a world that so desperately needs. Lord, we have many on our hearts that we've lifted up over the past weeks. Me, who's on hospice, that you would keep her comfortable. Bill Hall, who's still recovering. We don't lift up those that we know that have the virus, for Kathy, for Becky, for Cheryl, for Aaron, and for Mike. We want to lift up those we know that have cancer, for Perry Ashford, and for Mike. We lift up Perry's wife, Marie. She would also strengthen her body and help her as she takes care of her husband. We lift up Marlene to you. She's a dear member of our church family. We just ask you to bring healing to her body, and that she would be able to get more answers from the doctor this week. We lift up many families in our congregation that need your love. The Blues, Miss Mary and Joan Lanning, for Beulah and Geneva. We lift up Hope as well. These some older people in our congregation. We ask for your hope and your love to be felt in a special way this week. We especially also want to lift up the Johnsons and to pray for you and Crouchery. They broken into their buildings this week and things were stolen. And the things are things. And so I thank God that it was only things. But Lord, it also it helps to put fear in our hearts. And we just ask for healing for these folks as they're just navigating what's next and what the feeling is like. And to remind them it is just stuff. We also want to lift up all our churches, our local churches, to you as they make decisions for reopening. You will be with their pastors. Give them your wisdom and your sense of your love. We lift up our DS, Reverend Conaway, Lord, and we would ask for directions. We lift up our nursing homes to you, Lord, and we ask for your healing touch to be on where the virus has tried to spread, that you would squall that. You would protect the nurses and those that don't have the virus, that they would be able to find healing. Lord, we want to lift up Kay Moore, who's recovering from cellulitis. We lift up Jody's, who's planning to move, and I ask for a healthy pregnancy for her, and just for peace for her as she has decided to meet again. We lift up for all those who are developing a vaccine for this virus. It will be perfected soon. Lord, we lift up our healthcare workers and our frontline people, Lord, that you would keep them safe. Lord, we lift up those that are in that spaceship today and continue that they would be able to get their projects done and that you would keep them safe. Their unspoken requests are, I'm sure, on our hearts and minds, and I ask you to lift them up as well. We ask all these things in your name. Long prayer, right? Prayer is important, I'm finding out. And one of the things I'm able to do, I can't do much sometimes, I know I can always do. We're going to sing a Gaither song. There's just something about that name. Genesis 1, verses 1 through 8. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was now over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said that there be light, and there was light. And God saw that the light, it was good. And he separated light from the darkness. God called the light day. And the darkness he called night. And there was evening. And there was morning, the first day. And God said that there be a vault between the waters to separate water from other water. And so God made the vault and separated the water under the vault from the water above it, and it was so. And God called that vault the sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. Pretty familiar scripture here, right? It's good Sunday school stuff. Hopefully. With my notes, I decided to skip one of the illustrations. You'll get it eventually. Catch up to me. The work of creating begins with God in the book of Genesis. The Spirit of God swept over the waters and spoke creation into existence. God was on the move, and God is on the move now. In Genesis, God is creating and sweeping and speaking. We've all experienced times where we knew God took care of a situation for us. Or we've seen the power of God in our world. Becoming your pastor was such one of those God moments for me. So many things had to come together to bring it together, and God did it in God's time, of course. For you, maybe you've seen or you experienced a great time, a great movement. Maybe something scary like an earthquake, where the actual earth moved under you. Or maybe it could just be something exciting like moving to a new place or having a new job or career. As God creates, God sweeps over us and speaks to all creation. God is actually part of the movement. God moves the water of the Red Sea, moves the clouds for rainbows, parts heaven in Jesus' baptism, and an earthquake rocks the earth at the time of Jesus' death and resurrection. We see throughout the Old and the New Testament how God's movement continues. This contrasts with the idea that God simply creates the world and just lets it run its own course. Our God is not abstract and indifferent God. Our God is living and moving among us. God is continually creating and speaking, and is not limited to just nature. It also happens in individual and our communal lives as a church. In our baptism liturgy, we talk about the chaos that exists until God swept over the water. In sweeping over the chaos of our lives, God creates a clean heart in us, the start of something promised new. By uniting us in baptism, Christ unites us as a community, as a family, which participates together doing God's work in the world. Jesus empowers us. God can empower us to do dynamic movements in our church. The reason we can move, the reason faith can move mountains, is because God did it first. We are all created in God's image. Therefore, we can create also in God's creating, sweeping, and God's moving. Create new opportunities for people to invite the church when we're allowed to have more people, right? But we can also invite them for online prayer and share sermons. We can sweep over the needs of the community here in Fairton that is broken. With God's help, through faith, we can move mountains. Imagine a world with no movement, no breeze blowing, especially when the gnats come, right? Imagine that. Don't let this opportunity pass you by, because the world is waiting for us, the church, in our community. What are mountains that need to be moved? What are opportunities for us to be faithful? I challenge us right now to imagine sweeping across our neighborhoods with the power of God. What a difference God can make right here, there, right here in Cobble County. Let's pray. Lord, sometimes it's hard to know where to start when there's such a need. Lord, we ask that you would show us the ministry that we are to be involved in, that we would be faithful to your world that so desperately needs to hear about you. In your name. We are now going to have another Fairton favorite hymn, Here I Am, Lord. That's the first verse. You have to stand and kneel. Grace and peace, knowing God is with you. Now, get God with you. Hold on.
Nice seeing everyone. Yay. Very nice.